Hey, you doing here? Okay, so here's a little bit of more of a close-up of my side splash with all the masking tape off of it. And let's see if you can see that. There is the dividing line there between where I put new finish, where I had, you know, cut it, sanded it, rounded it off, and put new finish on it. So that's got to be sanded down flush. What I'm going to do, once it's dry, it's not dry enough to sand now, I'll put a piece, some masking tape across here, and then I can, you know, sand on this without scratching the original finish and try to get them flush. And I'm going to use, I've got 400 or 500, I think it's 500 maybe, wet dry sandpaper. And that way I won't, the end is really nice and smooth. That's what I wanted it. I mean, hopefully I can blend it in enough to where it'll, you'll really hardly be able to tell, and it's going to be shiny and smooth just like the original finish. So I actually got kind of lucky, because all the other sprays I did, where I'll put this back up here and get this, I can get a hold of it. This is my scrap piece that I kept, you know, testing my spray on. I think it'll make a nice coaster. It's a big one. Too little to do anything with, but too big to carry around. But anyway, I brushed it first, and I saw that that ain't going to work. So then I started spraying on it, and there's quite a few coats on it, but you can still see all the brush streaks. And I had a bad run the last time. My gun was dripping everywhere. You see all these drip marks on the table. But I kind of think the reason it might have been dripping was I actually forgot when I started spraying to readjust. You know, when you clean the gun, you got to adjust it to get the cleaner to spray out good. And let's put that up there, I guess. No, let's put it over here. I forgot to readjust it, but it was really, really fine, and it was, you know, just hardly acted like it was wanting to come out. But it ended up making a really smooth finish. Just took me a lot more passes. Took me so long that I think it was beginning to get too thick to spray. It was beginning to want to dry up. And I think the reason it was leaking out of the pot, the gasket's not so great. I redid it. It got to where it wouldn't even work anymore. But the pot was leaking. I'll kind of see if I can show. There's my old gasket. I put RTV automotive sealant in there. You can kind of see that redness, because the old gasket that came with it is so hard it won't seal anymore, so it had extra pressure, you know, because I had it screwed down. I had the adjuster screwed down real fine so that it would spray the acetone cleaner I was using. So I think it actually turned out, I didn't realize it till I was about done, and then I thought, well, it looks good, I'm not going to mess with it anymore, you know. I don't want to, because the other one, the bigger one that I made out of this size stuff right here that's already installed, you can kind of feel a little texture to it. It doesn't look bad, and you don't really see it until you get up close to it, but I think that's because I was really letting it go on thick. So, learned a lot. First time ever spraying gel coat at all, but especially on cultured marble. So here we go, let it dry, and we'll come back whenever we have it, when we get ready to finish this, sanding this, and put it in the bathroom. All right, bye.